Good afternoon. My name is Paul Smith. I'm the Global Field Operations Manager for Hyperloop One. Yes, I am British. And in case you're wondering, I voted firmly to remain in the EU because I believe we can do more together. And judging by what I've seen today, I'm in good company as well. So, who in the room, hands, show of hands, please, who knows what a Hyperloop is? Most people. That's good. So let me tell you about the theory. Let me tell you about Hyperloop One, and let me tell you why we're in Finland. In 2013, Elon Musk released a white paper about the Hyperloop concept. And it's essentially this. You take a pod, it can be carrying people, it can be carrying cargo, and you put it in a sealed tube. Why do you do that? Because if it's sealed, you can evacuate the air from it. You can create low air pressure, which means low resistance when traveling. You put this pod on a type of maglev system, which means there's no friction between the pod and the track, and then you automate this as well. So it can move with precision and at our control. That is what a Hyperloop is. Because there's no air resistance, because there's no friction, it means it can move very, very quickly. We're talking faster than commercial airliners. We're talking approaching the speed of sound through a tube, on the ground, or through the earth. That's what a Hyperloop is. Now, obviously, it's very, very quick, and that's nice, but speed is a feature. The benefit, or one of the benefits, is frequency. If you can automate this and you can travel quickly, you actually eliminate the need for timetables or schedules. You don't need them anymore. This will be on demand. But start thinking about how it changes where you live, where you work. The average commute is 30 minutes. Imagine if you can travel 300 kilometers in your average commute, where would you live and where would you work? How do you start building cities differently if you can transport freight and cargo as quickly as that? Where would you build ports? How would you build airports? Would you need that extra runway if an airport reaches capacity? Or could you create a Hyperloop to another distant runway and treat it as an air train? That's what Hyperloop is. We are a team of 280 people at Hyperloop One. We're the only company that is actually building a Hyperloop right here and right now. We have a 100,000 square foot factory in Nevada, and we've recently built this, the first test track. It's half a kilometer long. I wanted to briefly show you something that the world hasn't seen. That's our vacuum system. We are creating new systems to do this. That's the fourth largest vacuum system in the world after NASA and CERN. Why are we here? We're no strangers to Finland. We've been here for over a year working with our partners at TechS and FS Links. We did our first feasibility study here. So we've been on the ground for a while. Why we're here is because of the next step. In the coming weeks, you're going to hear some very exciting news from our dev loop in Nevada. The next step is proof of operations. This will help us test things at higher speed, but it also helps us start working on a regulation and legislation network and infrastructure. And we need to do that with people who will support us. We've had some great conversations with Team Finland. We'd hope to keep having them. We would love to build a proof of operations in Salo, for example. And we're here today to start identifying strategic partners and suppliers, so people working in precision engineering, people working in control systems, people working in engineering. I'm about to get kicked off, but big or small, we'd love to talk to you because we think we can do more together. Thank you very much.